What's going on? Killer Gameplay's back at you with the second level for Requiem. And this one is Templar's Library. We're going to go down into this subway here and do some exploring. It's the whole reason she's here in this mission. And we see some of the tracks are missing. They keep going, but we can't get to them. So we'll proceed down, check it out. First thing we can do, though, is jump to the left right here. It's kind of a tricky jump. And get a couple of pickups, and there's a gem. Another secret. So we got stuff happening right off the bat. Then we got a chain of events here. We're going to slide on some slopes, grab platforms, grab this one here, jump to the next one before the platform falls away. This one here, we'll just jump forward and grab. And you can do this fast, you can just run through it, but just kind of showing you a different way you can do it if you want to. Make it a little bit easier. And we'll enter this main hall where we need to find 4 gems. Blue gems to open the gate straight ahead. But first we're going to get a couple of pickups. We got these huge skeletons here and there throughout the level, just to decorate the place up. More shotgun ammo across the way, so we will be getting our shotgun pretty quick. And let's set in on some of these levers and open some doors. And you can see over here, I'll show you. Let me get this open. Got 4 receptacles for 4 gems and a gate that we need to open. So we'll go into this first room, and first thing I like to do, there's a hidden jump switch over here. So I like to get that out of the way, go ahead and open it. And I'll show you where that's at. Another pickup over here. So we need to work our way up, and this part right here is pretty tricky. What we're going to do is grab this edge, and we're going to backflip back and forth and jump to another slanted ledge, flip in the air, and grab. There'll be a lot of that. Jumping backwards and flipping. Grab another ledges. So we'll start in, and we're going to get it right up against this edge. As soon as we hit the corner of that one, backflip, spin. And your main 2 enemies in this level are spiders and those skeletons with swords that you can't really kill. You can just only when you shoot them, it just knocks them down for a little bit. It doesn't actually kill them. You know, you'd figure it'd break them apart, but it doesn't. Just temporarily stuns them. They get back up and they come right back at you again. So time out these spikes. And here's the gem. So, I mean, you ain't got to, but I'm going to go ahead and place these as I get them. You can wait till you get all 4 and then place them. Trying to lay this out simply so you can see what's going on. Next thing I like to do is go over here to this gate that we opened up. There's a skeleton in here asleep. As soon as we grab this upper ledge, he's going to wake up. There's a skull here we need. So we're going to get it, get back in the water before he stabs us. They will do a pretty good bit of damage. If you stand there about 3 or 4 hits and you're dead. So, the little bastard got me. There's some shotgun ammo here. So we're going to get that. Alright. You just stay in here. Forever entombed. You'll not be drawing blood on me anymore. Alright, here's the room where that skull goes. And we're going to use that skull to stop a fountain, some water flowing, to get to a switch and get to the gym. So each one of these rooms, the ultimate goal is to get the gym. Get some shotgun shells. And the cage we're trying to drop is up here at the very top. So there's our switch, and here's the fountain. We'll stop it up with that skull. Get a cinematic. Now it's dry in here where we can pull the lever, which will drop the gate. And one of the things the designer put in here for to be able to climb is vines. So you got some vines in this. Anytime you see vines, you can probably climb them. So we'll do that. Going to be a spider up here. We ain't sweating it. Alright, so gym number 2. Got 2 more rooms to check out. And we will move on to a big underground area. Not really like a city, but more like a little buildings underground. So we'll make some sense of the big earthquake that got Laura here in the first place. All right, so we'll open that door, and all you got to do here is just sprint forward. There's going to be some blades come up behind you, and we'll shoot this spider. Cool. And that's all there is to this room. You'll notice probably the hardest room in this area is the first one I did. And the one we're going to next would be the second hardest, I think. But very cool design on this game. I like this. This whole level is very cool. Done up by Ven Raider. And I believe this is a revised edition of this game. So we got slants on each side of the room, and we need to jump around this pillar. And the ultimate goal is to jump, to hop into the alcove in the back of the room. And that'll be where the last gym is. And you would think it'd be real easy, but it's kind of tricky. So you gotta jump, slide forward on these, and then curve to your left. So we're gonna slide down, curve, and there we go. Then he added plant vegetation in the way so you couldn't see, making it a little more tricky. There's our fourth gym. Before we leave, we'll grab some more ammo here. And get on up out of here. Move on to something else. You gotta kind of keep your eyes open in this TRLE, like this gate that opened. You might be wondering, well, how do I get in there? This is the way you do it. But at first glance, it'd be like, well, what in the hell do I do? So, lots of little things like that. And there's, watch out for this boulder. There's lots of tricky jumps, things that you have to do. This game will test you, this particular level will test your skills. We got a fall away bridge here. So we're gonna run forward. We're gonna slow down last couple of steps so we can get a jump. You can't jump from sprint. So you'll wanna let off of the sprint button. And get up into this next area. We'll get a cinematic. There's the Templar's Library. So we're going to be getting a few keys, going to be opening some gates, exploring a little bit. And you might have noticed in that cinematic, there's a key on the very top of a pillar. But first we're going to go in here into this big room and see if we can find a shotgun. Going to be bats in here. And there's some of those skeletons. Got to pick up for ammo. There's another one over here. And one over here. Die. Quit biting on me. Alright, there's a ladder over here. If we climb it, we can backflip, get to the shotgun. And, of course, another bat's chewing on my ears while I'm trying to climb a ladder. Take some of them out. And I believe there's a few that spawn outside. I believe those have come in here, so... Yep. All the bats found their way into this room. Come on now. Transport through the floor. There you go. Ammo here. And on these side alcoves where the skeletons are, there's more ammo on each side. Big old giant skeletons. Here's a shotgun. Let's go ahead and load that sucker up. And you'll notice that I don't really shoot these skeletons. It's kind of a waste of ammo. Unless I'm trying to shoot them off a ledge or get them out of my way and shoot them into a pool or something like that. It's a waste of ammo. Because they just get right back up. So what we're going to do here is we're going to lure them up to the top of these stairs. And we're going to sprint and get back to that lever and trap them in this room. Otherwise, they'll be bothering us the whole time out here in this town square. So there we are. All right, you little bloodthirsty shits. Y'all stay in there. All right, this pool at the top of the pillar, that's where the key is. One of the keys. But we'll go ahead and get a couple pickups while we're here. And move on to the next area. And there should be a skeleton following me. Let's see. Yep, there he is. Show you real quick, there's a gate we need to open. And that water has a current. It'll pull you to the left. There's a jump switch here. And what we're going to do is lure that skeleton where we can shoot him in the water so he's not jabbing us the whole time. We're trying to do stuff. Get this jump switch. Open the gate. And lure him over here. Come on, you little shit. Get in the water. There you go. Now he won't be bothering us. And we're going to dive at an angle. Remember, there's a current that'll pull you to the left. So we got to get in this alcove. Pull the lever. And I never tried to jump in there without pulling the lever, but it may drown you if you miss it. So we got a lever puzzle, underwater levers, and you'll notice some of these have skeletons or bones by them. We're going to pull the ones that don't have bones. We'll get this one, get a screenshot of the gate we're trying to open, and pull this one. And while we're up here, we'll get some flares. And I'm going to go back out and get some air. Got more levers down here we're fixing to come back to. And we're going to pull the first lever on the right and the very last on the right. So, of course, it's a puzzle. You know, if you pull the wrong one, spikes will come up and kill you. So you just have to go through it till you figure it out. But there's the gate open. There's a large med pack here. So we can go up through the gate and keep exploring. And you'll see some hints of Tomb Raider 2 here and there. Some of the graphics, some of the templates. As well as the good old spiders with the spider sound. Sounds like salt shakers. I've never heard a spider make that sound. Hey, before I forget it, there's a small med pack down here on the left. And we're going to grab this gate. And like I said, a lot of this, you'll be doing this a lot. We're going to backflip, spin, and grab. And we'll do it right here. Going to be a skeleton up in this room, but we need to pull a lever in here. And there he is on the right. You can shoot them down into the hole, but it's just quicker just to try to avoid them. And you couldn't see it, but we opened the gate. Here's some of that tricky jump I was talking about. We get right about in here, and we're going to slide forward and curve around the corner. And that is pretty tricky to do. Got a spider here. And some ammo we can pick up. And get up on this upper terrace. This looks like a good place for a screenshot. So just bear with me for a second. Oh yeah, that looks good. Boom. All right, we got a jump switch over to the right. We'll get lined up here. Do a sidestep. Pull up, backflip, and spin, and grab it. And enter into this room. We need to head all the way across the pool, but you can't pull up. So we're going to have to ride these slopes all the way across, which is pretty tricky to do. But first we can get some shotgun ammo. So I just went ahead and made this one long video. I believe there's 6 levels in this, so I'm going to just make them all one video. If they're an hour, so be it. I don't want to break them up into 2 parts. Slide forward, quickly, slide forward, veer to the left, and just slide straight down, man. Flip. Pretty easy, not too bad. Alright, so we got this lever we can pull. It's going to open a gate above us, back behind us, and we're just going to keep exploring. Got to go through all this to find the keys we need. There's a med pack. And we're fixing to face some pretty good challenges. And it's more just a skill challenge, really. Like right here, I'm gonna slide down backwards, grab, shimmy to the left. There's a dart trap right here, and what we've actually got to do is pull up, jump, and backflip spin, grab the edge. What we're going to do here to avoid the darts, the spikes, we're going to pull up, backflip, spin, and press to the right and grab these vines. If you don't press to the right, she'll fall right into the spikes. The spikes will activate. And she's dead meat. Probably doesn't look like it's too hard to do unless you're playing it. Alright, we're going to sidetrack and go get another secret gem. Jump across to this other building. Getting kind of high up in the air now. Shimmy all the way to the left. We'll pull up and get up on the rooftop of this building. And right here we'll have to press forward for her to get on up. And sometimes you have to do that, you'll have to press forward to get that little bit of extra inertia to do what needs to be done. Here's the second gem. And here we are up on top of the building. Keep in mind the key on top of that pillar. So we are way up. We're working our way to the Templar Library key. But we have to go back up to where we were, which is means we're going to have to redo all the same moves we did. Pull up here, back flip, spin, grab, shimmy to the left, yada yada. Repeat and repeat. Rinse, wash, and repeat. Pull up, back flip, spin, press to the right, grab. So you're doing about 7 things real quick right there. Alright, almost to the key, and the reason we've started out at the water level puzzle to get here, we're about to get it done. We've got a balcony and a gate we need to open. I'm gonna grab this bookcase, shimmy to the left, and get to the switch to open the gate. There will be another tarantula spider up here. Making his sounds. Very, very much out of Tomb Raider 2. Pendulum trap. And we can finally get to the key. I was trying to remember which level. Here's the key. I believe it was Temple of Zion that all those spiders are around, and you get up to a spider den where there's some big spiders and very cool level. There's a skeleton down here. I'm just going to avoid him. By the way, I covered Tomb Raider 2 if you're new to the channel and you want to go check out that Temple of Zion. Of course, they use a lot of those elements in these Tomb Raider, the TRLEs, when they build them. So it's up to the designer to pick what, choose what they want. Right, so back to this open court. What are you doing, you couple of weasels? Y'all still bloodthirsty? Yep. Right, let's. There's the key we just got. There's the keyhole. And there's some pickups. There's large med pack, ammo, and flares over here. And we'll go around to the left. There's going to be another skeleton pop up from the depths of Hades. Little evil skeleton. Old Nosferatu. Alright, a couple of pickups. There is a small med pack if I can get to it. But he's not going to give me time to get to it. Yep. Let's get rid of these skeletons. We're going to go over here by this pool of water, break out the shotgun, get in position where we can shoot them in the water. Come on over here, you little shits. And this is what you got to do to them. As you can see, shooting them does no good. They just get right back up. So you got to shoot them off a ledge or shoot them in the water, like I was saying. There's place for another key here. This is a big main hall. Pretty cool area. We'll be getting to that. And we can finally get the small med pack. By the way, back over here, there's a door on ground level we need to open. But we'll have to go through that hall and all its traps to open that door. And what we're doing is entering the Templar Library to get the key to open the big hall to get that done. So we're swapping a key for a key, so to speak. And for some reason, my Bandicam isn't showing the pop-ups, but she entered a page in her diary. Says, we will have to ignite some bowls. There must be a hint somewhere to differentiate them. Maybe in the room below. Anyway, I should better have the right combination before trying anything, as it seems that I have only one chance. So, using the binoculars there, we see the stained glass window as a clue, and I'll show you what I mean here. I'm going to pick up some ammo. Basically, there's symbols underneath these bowls, these right here, and the Omega symbol is the ones we need to light. I'll show you. Plus, there's a door down here we need to open. That's the final goal, to get the key to. And you see right there. Fortunately, I figured everything out, so you can just check out what I'm doing. There are a few pickups down here. And this can be a little tricky here. We need to get back up out of here. Whoa, just barely. Alright, so there's a jump switch up here we need to keep in mind on the corner of that building. And, of course, We need to do a timed run to get a torch, light it, and light the proper bowls to open the door down in the dungeon to get a key so we can move forward. Keep in mind these spike traps. They will activate during the timed run. Basically, we're running from one balcony to the other during the timed run. And let's kill this spider. The ultimate goal is to get into this gate straight ahead. It's this will be the way we go. But first we need to get to this jump switch. There we go. That's going to open the gate on the right side of the balcony. So we'll go back up there. And when we pull up to the right, there'll be some uninvited guests. Some of the hairy tarantulas, spiders coming after us. So we'll get rid of them before the timed run. Got enough to do without dealing with spiders, poisonous bites, things of that nature. So it'd be a good idea to save here in case you don't make it. We're going to sprint wherever we can, time it out, sprint. Watch these spikes. It's pretty tight, so you want to be quick. Now we see some flames ignited over here. We're going to jump over them to the roof. And shimmy to the left. Backflip. Get in the gate before it closes on us. Whoa. So you see how quick I was, and it closed right behind me. So we're going to pull this switch twice to open the gate. Got some pickups in here, and we get the torch. Here's a bat, little vampire bat. Cool. Grab a torch. And we can head down to the bowls and light the correct ones to open the door down in the dungeon. So quite a little bit going on in this level. Got a little ways to go too. So just keep your eye on the ones I'm lighting here. If it shows a spike trap, but there's no spikes activate. And we'll get that door open down in the dungeon. And of course our buddies are still down there. So we'll just jump over. But there's still that problem of getting back out of here. Here's the key to the big hall. Shit. Just had to hit me one time before we left. Oh. Alright. Cool. Got rid of that. Got that out of the way. Alright, so we go over here to a whole brand new level. This area here, we'll have to work our way up to the top, get a gem, place it, and open the back gate behind the big hall building right here to ultimately finish up the level. So we got lava below. Got a couple hundred feet above us. It's just a recipe for disaster. Something tells me Laura's going to pull through it. Before we even start, we'll go ahead and save. This area is not very hard. It's just playing through it a couple of times. We're going to backflip, spin, grab. Got a slanted ledge here. We're going to pull up. Flip in the air, spin. Then we can backflip, spin, and grab the ladder behind us. Go up to a lever that's going to open a trap door right above us so we can keep going up. Need to work our way up. Get a cinematic, but it doesn't really show anything. Shows us where we'll be in the future. Coming up. But actually, what it did, like I said, was raise this platform right here so we can climb the ladder. So, get your skills ready here. We're going to backflip, spin, grab, slide forward, slide, veer to the left, and we're just going to jump back and forth. Then we're going to spin, slide down, shimmy to the right, and then we'll backflip and spin. Grab. Got a boulder trap in front of us. What we're going to do, get a running jump, jump, slide forward, jump, and then backflip and slide forward again. And there's the gem we're trying to get to. So we have to go get up higher to get to it. Can't get to it from here. Got a blade trap here. So we'll sprint, jump, grab here, backflip, spin, and grab, and then climb the ladder. Got some to make things even more hairy than they are and harder. We got pendulum traps up here and time flames up here. So we're gonna wait and let it get out of our way. And remember, the gem's over to the left. I got my way, I like to do this. We're going to time the flame out. We're going to jump forward, spin in the air. Grab the edge at the bottom of the slope. And just backflip. Voila. Ta-da. Laura's getting it done. We'll slide forward to the edge. Let her feet get to the edge. Otherwise, she'll miss. And we need to work our way back up. Like we know what we're doing. Get back through this sword trap, blade trap. And Wash, rinse, and repeat. Repeat and repeat. Pretty damn good challenge in here. I like it. And there we are, man. We're at the top. We got the gym. We can place it over here. And it doesn't show it, but it opens a gate back behind the hall, the big hall. We haven't been back here yet, but it's just a rocky area behind this building. And this is the actual door that opened right there before we can get in. So all that to open the gate. Hey, no handbook on this, man. You just got to get in the corner, backflip, grab this edge. Ain't no special way to do it. We're trying to work our way over to that lever. We're going to grab, we're going to slide down to the edges of these, grab this edge, then we can run and jump. There we go. That actually opened a gate straight ahead. That's going to help us to keep going. A couple of pickups here. And if you're still watching, thanks for tuning in. I know this is a long video. There's the back of that hall. Try to keep it interesting enough to keep watching. Some of these videos in this are going to be long. The next levels will be in a completely different place, different environment. You'll see at the end of this video. So we'll be swapping it up. Get out of this old dark dungeon. Get in some sunshine and some desert, and she can put on her tank top and shorts, and we'll, so it doesn't stay one vibe through the whole game. We'll swap it up. Got a spider and got some shotgun ammo. So we're working our way around to the front side of this building. Remember, we still haven't got that key that's on top of the pillar. That's going to be goes to the last door at the end of the level, which is coming up pretty soon. We'll get the Holy Grail and complete this mission. Yeah, we've got a skeleton here. We need to shoot his ass off the side. See ya. Damn sure wouldn't want to be ya. Pull this block back 4 times. And this will be one of those instances you'll see here that we need. We got a pretty good jump. First off, we're going to save. Second off, we're going to have to press forward with all our might and hit the action button to get a little bit more distance. And here's the key, man. All that work for that key. But what we're going to have to do is go all the way back up where we just were before we jumped off. The actual door for the end level's up on our left, up above us. So, got to work around the building and get over there. Back up through the rocky crags. Up the ladder, around to the front of the building. By the way, I haven't forgot, I've got a couple of levels left in Tomb Raider Anniversary. I haven't forgot about that. For those who might be wondering about that, I need to finish it up. And then, of course, I've got on my other channel, I've got, oh no, Crunch. I'll see you back. Like I was saying, on my other channel, Premiere Playthroughs, I'm just about finished up on Tomb Raider 2013. If you want to go over there and check it out or subscribe, I'm not pushing that, just... But I am at the end of finishing a couple of games, kind of clearing out the space to pick something else. So I'll keep you informed on that. We're going to jump around the corner here. This is going to be our way over to the left. By the way, there's some ammo you can pick up there, but you have to go all the way back up through the rocky crag to get there, to get back up here. I don't think one clip for ammo is good enough reason to do that, but they're there if you want them. We'll insert the key, and I'll go ahead and read this Holy Grail. It says, let's see here. It's awesome. According to the scroll, knights of the temple would have discovered the Holy Grail during the Crusades in Israel. Apparently, the sanctuary is located somewhere under the Har Megiddo dig site. The well-known legend says it can give immortality, but does not interest me as long as the cup shines well in my trophy room. It's weird. Why did the Templars let the Grail and lock the sanctuary instead of bringing it back with them? With such an artifact, they could have had pressure on the Vatican and got all the power they wanted. Never mind. I've got enough information to get what I found. So there's our clue going into the next level. Har Megiddo, I believe is what he's calling it. Level 3. So thank you for tuning in. Templar's Library, level 2. And you're watching Killer Gameplays. Catch me on the next one. It's going to be cool. Y'all take it easy.